Dueling Dialogues presents His and Hers with Grace Matthews, Caddy Man, and Connor Murphy.
Field, Missouri. Hi, you two.
Hello. How are you?
Good.
Hey, what's happening?
Not a lot, you know. Starting to look like and feel like fall out there.
Yeah, today's the first day of fall.
It is.
That's right. Well, no wonder.
Happy fall. No wonder it looks a little like fall.
Yeah.
I'm feeling it. Today's the first day I've had a jacket on. So.
Well, we basically skipped spring and summer this year for some reason. It seemed like it anyways.
Yeah. We had a very short season. We had some wonderful hot weather, but it was like, you know, 4 or 5 weeks.
Yeah. Well, you're luckier than we are.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we were. We were definitely luckier than you.
Yeah, I'd say 2 weeks of summer weather. That's all we got this year.
But I do like fall, too. I like apples. I like the smell of apple butter.
I don't like the fruit flies.
Yeah, that's true. In the midst of COVID, I'm afraid that some of the fall activities are going to be curtailed.
Right.
But you know what? Make your own.
Yeah, what's happening with Halloween? I guess it's going to be different everywhere.
I just can't imagine that they would risk children being exposed through candy wrappers to COVID-19.
Right. Will this be the end of Halloween?
Will it ever come back?
Yeah, I don't know.
Good question.
I don't know.
Yeah, sometimes those are the best things that come up in these shows.
This is about the earliest I've ever seen the candy out in the stores, too. They had it out.
Yeah, but they didn't have that much.
No, not that much.
They have predicted no trick-or-treating.
Huh. Wow.
You know, mom and dad will just have to buy the kids some candy and, I don't know, put on the outfit and do Zoom. Have a Zoom happy hour.
Sad. Sad.
Yeah, so I don't know. Our thought for the week is it's easier to tell the truth the first time around.
No shit.
You gotta go backtrack. You know what? It turns into a mess.
Yeah.
And then, you know, one lie leads to another. And, you know, even when it's uncomfortable, just tell it the truth the first time around.
Yeah, I'm a firm believer in that.
Yeah.
One lie leads to another. So don't start the chain.
Exactly. And, you know, sometimes those people that do want to lie are also the fake apologists.
Of course, they're the one and the same.
We all had those people in our lives, especially in the office.
Yeah.
You know, they apologize, but it's kind of like, I'm so sorry that I'm not sorry.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, well, I've got some, I've got like about 13 common fake apologies.
Oh, I didn't know there was that many.
Oh. Yeah. Okay, first is the minimizing apology. That's the one that starts with, I was just.
Okay.
As you might guess, first is, I was just kidding.
Okay. Yeah.
Jerk. I was just trying to help.
Yeah.
You know, older women use that one.
Yeah.
You know, that passive aggressive aunt or, you know, somebody's mother. I was just trying to help. Or, you know, I love this one that you get from a friend. I was just playing the devil's advocate.
Yeah. Or the one that starts with, no offense, but.
Yeah. You know, and those are hurtful.
Yeah, well, it's at least there's a warning that you're going to be offended.
Hold on to your tail because it's going to get slapped.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly. Okay, now we go to the next guy. The shift the blame apology.
Oh, lovely.
I'm sorry that you think I did something wrong.
Okay.
I've actually used that one before. I'm not proud of it.
Yeah, I have too, unfortunately.
It really is bad.
That's one that's used at work.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm sorry you think I did something. Yeah.
Right.
And then that makes you, you know, that makes the person, the victim sort of like, you know, I'm crazy, which is a little bit like gaslighting, but that's another topic for another episode. But how about, I'm sorry that you feel I am a bad person. Oh, I've got a friend that says that all the time.
Ouch. Wow.
And especially in reference to Facebook.
Right.
I'm sorry that person thinks I'm bad. I mean, okay, you know, first of all, I'm always annoyed at people that take Facebook and Twitter too seriously.
Right.
Okay, those people are not in your house, and unless you've told them your address, they really don't have it. So don't take it that seriously.
Right.
Okay, here, how about, I am sorry, but maybe you're just too sensitive.
Okay. Now, ouch.
Some people are too sensitive, but, you know.
Yeah.
Conditional thing. Okay. Which leads me to, of course, the conditional apology. I'm sorry if something I said offended you.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. I think I've used that before, too.
Yeah,
seriously.
Everybody's used that one. It's almost like a standard.
I mean, after reading these, I'm probably not going to do some of these again.
Yeah, me too. Actually, that's what the silence has been.
Yeah, I'm sorry if your feelings were hurt. I've used that, too.
Yeah.
I'm sorry if I may have done anything wrong.
Okay.
Is that like asking for a carte blanche to do something wrong then?
Yeah, it's a blank
and
list.
Covering the basis for when you do this.
Yeah.
Have I ever done something wrong ever?
Yeah, and if I do anything in the future, then just take it down, write it down.
Yeah, write it down, put it on the list.
I'm sorry.
Which is also the next one, the deja vu apology. Okay, I already said I was sorry.
Oh boy.
I have apologized for that a dozen times. And regardless of whether I keep doing it or not,
yeah.
I have apologized a dozen times.
Yeah, like, exactly. If you have to apologize a dozen times, you need some, self-examination going on there.
Remember last week was, do you need a therapist? Okay, if you have to apologize a dozen times for the same thing, get a therapist. Okay, how about the phantom apology? This is great. I regret that you felt upset.
Okay. I find a lot of these are very similar.
Oh, yeah. What about this one? I regret that mistakes were made.
Yeah. Not that
I did the mistake.
It looks like they just happened.
Yeah.
You know, there's a ghost in the room.
Well, they could be used to mistakes following them around for a reason.
Yeah, exactly. If you're having to do that, you know, talk about that a lot, maybe you should re-examine yourself. What about whitewashing the apology? I probably shouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
Oh boy, how many times have I heard someone say that? Maybe I should have asked you first.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. Okay, here's the great one. The nothing to apologize for apology.
Oh, okay. This will be good.
You know, I've never hurt you. You know that I'm sorry. And you know that I didn't mean that.
Yeah. Okay.
So why the hell did you say it?
Exactly.
Okay, here's a good one. The invisible apology. I guess I owe you an apology.
Oh, yeah, I guess I do.
I guess I should say I'm sorry.
I guess so.
I guess so. How about the pay-to-play apology? I'll apologize if you will.
Oh.
I will apologize if you agree never to bring it up again.
Yeah.
We've heard that one, haven't we?
Yeah.
I will apologize, but you have to forgive me. I mean, some of these sounds like five-year-olds.
Yeah, you know? Exactly.
Yeah, the not my apology. Okay, your mother told me to apologize to you.
I've been told.
I should tell you I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I don't know where the one is that says I'm apologizing for my mother. I used to apologize for my brother. You know, not my mother, my brother.
There you
go. I've actually done that. I mean, when he was a little kid, he would like headbutt my dates. I'm sorry about him. You know, okay. The takeaway apology. I'm sorry, but other people thought what I said was funny. I'm sorry, but you started.
Okay.
I mean, these definitely sound like middle school.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but I just couldn't help it. I love people that can't help their own.
Wait a sec, I'm writing that one down.
Yeah, that's a good one. And that's when you're having happy hour. Oh, I'm sorry, I can't help it. I drank one too many shots of tequila.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm sorry, but I was just speaking the truth.
Yeah, whose truth? Yeah.
Yeah. Here's the one size fits all. I am sorry for all the things that I have done to upset you. I've heard that one a lot.
Cover the bases.
Exactly. I apologize for every bad thing I've ever done in my life.
Yeah.
Don't start naming all those, please.
Okay, here's the last category. The get off my back apology. Fine, I'm sorry, okay. Here's the one my dad, I think, used to say. Okay, I'm sorry, for Christ's sake.
Oh, too funny.
I'm sorry, all right?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you know, we're up here in Canada, we're known for saying sorry. So
yeah,
that
you guys do apologize for everything.
Everything.
You gotta use this one. What do you want me to do? Climb up on the cross?
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, that's bad. That's bad. It's true.
I'm writing that one down.
I mean, if you're gonna apologize, apologize. If you're not gonna apologize, don't apologize. And not everything you do requires an apology, even if it upsets somebody.
Yeah, we even train customer service and tech support people to have empathy. And a lot of the time it's fake. They start off by saying, oh, I'm sorry you're having troubles today. No, you're not. You wouldn't have a job if I didn't have troubles.
That's true. It's job security, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
There's a lot of really bad things that are job security.
Absolutely.
You know, I mean, if they didn't happen, I mean, what about insurance?
Yeah.
You know, what about cancer drugs? I mean, you know, that's why we don't have a cure for cancer. It's too big an industry.
Right. Absolutely.
Too big to fail. So.
Who knows?
I don't know. I mean, and it kind of goes with our next category. We wouldn't want those companies don't want self-sabotage. So, if they come to a cure, that's kind of sabotaging their own industry.
Yep, right? It is.
What we're talking about is people that sabotage themselves. We are our own worst enemies.
Yeah, sometimes I believe that.
We do the most stupid stuff to ourselves. So we have 10 tips for avoiding self-defeat. And hopefully this helps you reach your goals. Because as long as you're beating yourself up, you can't reach your goals. You're spinning. Okay, when something bad happens, accept defeat. Put down your own gavel and replace the judgment with self-compassion. And when you use self-compassion, you can recover more quickly.
Okay.
I honestly haven't been drinking.
anyway. Yet.
That's exactly right. And, you know, that's probably the problem. I mean,
could
I'm
be.
I'm a blocker, and it's 5:16.
I'm so sorry you're having trouble talking.
Okay, separate yourself from your shortfalls and see them for what they are. They're habits, old behaviors, okay?
Okay.
They're patterns. Just make their mistakes. Okay, change them if you don't like them.
Yeah, move on. Pivot.
Move on. Yeah. Okay, now number three, you don't like the crap you're doing to your body, then stop it. Think of forgoing and not having that cigarette, beer, or extra piece of cake. You know, earlier you were talking about bubble buns.
Yeah, yeah.
It's... And you said I had five.
Yeah.
You didn't have six, right?
Right, I didn't. I knew when to quit.
So, take care of yourself.
You're a bigger
But also, don't
five.
Deprive yourself. I mean, you don't want to deprive yourself of your bubble buns.
You bet. You bet. Make sure you have room for at least five.
Exactly. And I could take five right now. And not be a bit sad. Okay, don't get fooled into just looking at where you want to land and feeling disheartened that you haven't reached your goal. Learn to look back about where you came from. Love the journey.
Good.
Journey is what you'll always look back at. Once you achieve your goal, it's the journey you'll remember.
Yeah, there you go.
That's true. So hard to do when you're doing it.
Yeah, for sure. True. Yeah, okay. Step back for a second.
And you've got to learn to comfort yourself and work things out. So number five is talk yourself off the ledge. Be comforting. Learn to self-talk. Give yourself pep talks. Use supportive words if you have to. It reduces stress and helps you hop back into the saddle. In fact, some of the, the little exercises that they use, that the Caddy Man uses for his OCD are a lot about being self-supportive.
Yeah, when things go wrong for me, I kind of talk to myself. I use an awful lot of swear words though when I talk to myself.
Well, you'd be surprised what I call myself.
Yeah,
that's another story for another show for sure.
Yeah.
Pinpoint the challenge, okay? When you pinpoint the challenge, then pinpoint the solution and the opportunity.
Right.
Sometimes the opportunity is difficult to pinpoint. Okay? And, a lot in the face of COVID, we're faced with that. For example, Caddy Man's getting ready to go on the road when COVID hit and do some speeches.
Right.
Well, guess what? People aren't gathering.
Yeah.
So now we just learned that we're going to have to come up with kind of a workshop.
Cool. Okay.
And, it's like at first it's like, oh, darn, how could COVID come along when we're getting ready to do this? But really it's turned into, oh, cool.
Yeah. Sometimes it's not noticeable. Like you said earlier, sometimes it's not noticeable right away. But everything happens for a reason, and you kind of got to leave your ear to the ground for a long time sometimes to realize why things happen that way. But, when you thought the world was ending 3 years ago, it didn't end, did it? And when you look back at it now, you're in a better place now. So you got to really look at the positives, because every negative, there's positives that will come out of it. But sometimes you got to wait for a bit.
Yeah. And when you get setbacks like that, or you make mistakes, look at them as lessons, just basically like you just
exactly.
said. Exactly. Instead of failure, make it an endurance.
Right.
You're in it for the long haul, the journey. Number eight, remind yourself of how a setback can make you stronger. It's kind of almost a repeat.
Yeah.
More resilient. And use the personal resources you have to get back up on the saddle.
Right.
That inner feeling in your gut that says, I can do this. It may not be the way I planned.
Right.
But the journey's just going to be a little bit different.
Exactly. Pivot.
Look at the big picture and broaden your outlook.
There's usually two ways to get to the same point.
That's true. Yeah, there's some.
I'm known for not taking the most direct route.
Yeah, I never do either. I usually take the hardest one.
Usually has some detours and stopping points and road under construction.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Remember, number 10, remember this. Success and failure are a package deal. You will not gain any success without a few failures along the way. As long as your zigzag keeps spiraling upward, you're on the right track to success.
Yeah, you bet. Sometimes I like to think of it as failures create new opportunities.
Absolutely. I mean, where do you think most of the recipes came from?
Exactly. Yeah.
You know, somebody dumped the wrong damn thing into the bowl.
Yeah, but ooh, that doesn't taste very well.
Exactly. Okay, we have three self-defeating habits to quit doing. Okay. Just real quickly.
Just three.
Quit complaining. Stop complaining. It's negative.
Okay.
It is, you know, Buddhists call it poisonous medicine.
Right.
It is poison. Complaining is poison. And if you're around people that complain all day, get away from them.
Yeah, absolutely.
It'll bring toxic.
Okay. Self-neglect. When you neglect your body, your mind, your spirit, you don't exercise, you don't have healthy habits, you don't give your mind appropriate stimulation, you're self-neglecting yourself. Okay, so I put doubles in there. But we are our own worst enemies, okay? And if you self-neglect, you are destined for anxiety and depression.
Right.
I mean, it's like neglect equals depression and anxiety.
Yeah, I'm agree with that. Yeah, I totally agree with that.
I do too.
Okay, number three, the worst of the worst, procrastination.
Uh-oh.
When you procrastinate, you're not getting anything done, and you feel isolated, you distrust people, you are emotionally fragile. Procrastination is probably the worst of the three.
Ew, okay. It's the one I'm most guilty of.
Does that mean, why should I do it today when I can always do it tomorrow?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay, what if tomorrow didn't come because you procrastinated today?
I agree.
That's what Sadhguru would say.
Exactly.
Yeah. Isn't it so?
Isn't it so?
Tomorrow never comes, isn't that a song?
Is it?
I don't know
either, but it should be.
Yeah,
it should be a twangy country song.
It is.
Oh, it is.
Yeah. Yeah, hit the nail on the head that time.
Okay, so back to 2.5 men.
Okay,
everybody seemed to enjoy that a little bit last week. This week it's who was the smartest.
Okay.
Who was the smartest character? Who do you think the smartest was?
I'm going to go with a far-fetched one.
Okay.
I'm going to say Berta.
Okay, what are you going to say there, Connor?
I really have no idea. I don't think I watched the show enough to give an opinion, proper opinion.
Well, I tell you what, it's a little surprising. Except number 10, Candy.
Oh, God.
That was...
I could tell by the name.
Okay.
Yeah.
And number 9's not that surprising either. That's Jake.
Yeah.
Although, I think Jake was smarter than that. I would have put him up higher. Number 8 is Walden.
Okay.
Walden made a list?
Yeah, I was a little surprised he did. But he was supposed to be a real smart guru, you know?
Right.
Having all the money in the IT, you know, video market. Number 7, Charlie.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Ouch.
Yeah.
Number 6, Rose. Crazy stalker Rose.
Huh.
Number 5, Dr. Melnick. Herb.
Okay.
Number 4, Cranky Chelsea.
Oh.
Number 3, Crankier Judith.
So number cranky two, crankiness oh. means you're smarter?
Evelyn.
I don't know.
So Alan's going to be number 1.
Alan is number 1.
Berta didn't even make the list.
She didn't even make the list. They said he was started out as a struggling single parent who was hapless but honest. But after a while, he realizes that mooching off of Charlie has its perk. And quickly, he becomes what everybody else always said he was. And he did it, and he got all the free stuff.
Yeah. Okay, there you go.
Can't argue with that, really.
No, yeah. I guess you can't. Definitely, you can't.
That did make it work, yeah.
I don't know. Okay, yeah. Connor, take it away.
All right. So yeah, we've got five shows that we're going to introduce you to this week. Again, some great TV. We're in the IMDb database rating between 8.9 and 8.6, so they're all up there and in popularity for sure. One that I just finished watching a few weeks ago was Justified, and that's on FX, Sony, KVH, and Amazon. And it's an action crime drama, and stars Timothy Oliphant, and he plays a marshal that's kind of like an old school marshal in modern day. Except you kind of expect him to ride a horse at some point, but if you expect that like I did, you're going to be disappointed because he never gets on a horse. But you expect to see it. It's a real gritty kind of crime show, so it's really, really a good one. And Timothy Oliphant is a great actor, does great job on the character as well. So that's one. About a year ago, everybody started posting pictures all over social media of the Mini Yoda, right? You'd see him on Facebook and Twitter, the Mini Yoda, the Yoda baby, or whatever you call him. And that's from the TV show The Mandalorian, and that's on Disney Plus and Walt Disney Television. It's an action-adventure sci-fi. It's basically a chapter out of Star Wars. So,
That sounds really good.
Yeah, and the Mandalorian is a bounty hunter, basically, and just the story of his life and how he wanders across Baby Yoda and ends up with Baby Yoda. There's only, I think, six episodes, which was kind of disappointing because people really wanted more right off the bat. So, that brings us to The Boys, and that's a show on Amazon. It's an action comedy crime, and basically it's a little different of a superhero story because the superheroes aren't necessarily good people. And they kind of abused some of their superpowers, and it's the story of how they became superheroes as well. So very interesting, very different. If you're into superheroes or comic book kind of TV shows, check this one out. It's very different. So now
kids would like that.
Yeah.
Now one that is an older show, lots of episodes and seasons, I think six or seven seasons, I can't even remember already, is The House of Cards, and it's the political show on Netflix, Sky, and Sony. Kevin Spacey and Robin Wright. Basically, it's a congressman and just political stuff that goes on in Washington. So a very interesting, very addictive show. So good one for binge watching. And the last one, which is one of my favorites this week, is called Fargo. And do you remember the movie a few years ago called Fargo?
Yes.
With Frances McDormand in it?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So it's very similar. The first season, at least, is very similar to the movie, which basically was a true story. Some very weird stuff happens in Minnesota. Very weird crimes and very bizarre stuff, and you just can't write this stuff in fiction. So it's the story of some of these crazy intrigue and murder cases that go on in frozen Minnesota. So definitely check it out. We're due for a new season. We were due for a while. There hasn't been a new season, but as far as I know, the show's not canceled. I think there's three or four seasons that you can check out now, three seasons or something. So that's it.
Well, thanks for that. That's great. And so check those out this week, because Connor will have some more next week.
You bet. We got lots.
We're hoping everybody has a happy and safe week. Remember our affirmation. We are messengers in love, happy, healthy, financially prosperous, great partners and parents. We are charitable, energetic, creative trendsetters that experience success every day. Tempest fugit. Time flies. Use it wisely.
Move that coffee table.
There you go. Here, here. You two have a great weekend.
You too.
All right. See ya.
Bye-bye.